We call it Untitled Goose Game. Tasselfoot, world record holder, is in the house. He's going to be taking us through an all main tasks run. The Goose is going to be getting into all sorts of trouble. Like, for example, hey, out there, do we have any fans of, breaking the dartboard? How about getting the Goose on TV? Any fans of that? I know you guys are going to love this. How about raking the lake? You guys are going to be seeing all those and more right now while I throw it up the task. Let's get your honks out for them for Untitled Goose Game.
What's up, GDQ?
Hey, everybody. I'm Tasselfoot. Please call me Tass. This is Untitled Goose Game. Welcome to Awful Goose Done Quick. I just want to test something really quick. Honk?
Honk.
Honk.
Honk?
Honk. All right, cool. This is what it's like to be a rock star. So just really quickly before we get going, I want to introduce the couch. Couch, if you want to say
Hi,
who you are.
Hi, I'm Yisk. I'm the current Any% world record holder for this game.
And we want to make sure, please, meet the donation so that Yisk gets to show off all the ridiculous glitches that there are in Any%.
Yep. I'm Shattermage. I also run all main tasks like Tasselfoot does. I'm the former world record holder in this category.
I'm ritzblues. I've run this category before. I'm also a former world record holder for 100%.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm Aquana. I'm also a former world record holder in 100%, and I've also run all main tasks before.
So all main tasks is we're going to showcase every single task that you can get before the credits of the game. No hidden tasks, no speed tasks. And we're going to get started right now for you guys, because I know you are looking forward to honk. Timing is going to start on first honk. So if we can count it down from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
honk!
Hello, I am Goose. So this is all main task, and there are not too many glitches, I will say that, throughout the run. Again, more reason to donate for Yisk Any%. His run is all glitches. However, we are gonna do a thing right there. Technically not a glitch. technically not. That's allowed in glitchless categories. We're just gonna go right through there. So this game has 4 main areas, and we have to perform like 6 to 7 tasks in each area, which will then unlock a final task. This is Groundskeeper Willy. He is going to be, we're gonna be fighting with him mano a guso in the beginning of this game here. And so I waited there in front of that gate because it's gonna aggro him down into the lake, which he needs to get wet. That's one of the tasks, and he will do that. He just went and slapped a demulch, which is fine. Each area has a gather task. These are the longest ones in each area, and the longest of those is the picnic. And so we need all of these items. We need 4 items from within the garden as well. That's what we're gonna spend most of our time here in the garden doing, is doing these gather tasks. We just gotta grab his keys real quick though. No big deal. The biggest part of RNG throughout the entire run, and this game is full of RNG, is right here. That's fine. This is actually not fine. It'll be, all right, cool. No big deal. Everything's fine. We need to get the jam, the pumpkin, and the thermos from inside, and we do need him to see that they are missing, otherwise we're just gonna lose some time. But Groundskeeper Willy, he can start in like 8 different spots, and then he can go to any of those other spots after about 5 seconds. So trying to manage where his position is throughout the garden is the hardest part of the entire run. Most resets for this category happen, and actually most categories happen here in the garden. That's fine. Everybody brings a pumpkin to their picnic, right? Like, that's pretty normal.
I bring a pumpkin to my picnic, too.
Yeah.
Have one without it.
I like cabbages, too.
Cabbages. I don't really know where Willie is right now. That's slightly problematic. Oh, cool. He's over here.
Oh, great. Great RNG we got here.
Terrible RNG, but that's fine. We're just going to honk him over here. And then we're going to use that water. Basically, he's going to go over there. He's going to hear the water. And this whole game is full of, like, prioritization and just the NPCs kind of figuring out what's missing and, like, thinking about it a lot. So he's now thinking about his thermos. We also need to get his hat. We need to get Rake in the lake. And we're just going to do all of those things. We also need a carrot. It's the last thing we need for the picnic basket. So we're just going to take that hat. It's no big deal. Pretty precise place. We got to drop it right there. And he's just going to wonder about his hat, and we're just going to steal this rake. And he's not going to see us at all. Or he is. And he's going to take it from us. That is.
Oh, no.
That is not nice. No. That is nice, not at all. This is what I was talking about when it comes to the RNG. Because he didn't. He just took it. That's just not nice at all, man. Because he didn't see the pumpkin earlier, he had to aggro on it now. And that was a little unfortunate. Physics is a little weird in this game, too. We're kind of stuck right now.
You can do it. Come on.
It's.
The other end?
Maybe we'll go the other side.
There we go.
Yeah. So.
Oh, no.
Oh, okay. All right. Now he's wondering what happened to the rake. It's fine. We're going to go to right there, not actually the lake, because we need that carrot first. And when we get the carrot, it's going to trigger his final task. You have to do all of the tasks minus one in order to get the final task. So he's going to go over to do that, which is putting up a sign, and then we're going to honk, and then he's going to, like, fall on his butt.
Let's go. Let's
go. Rake in the lake. All right. We're done.
Yeah. Hey.
just the tip there. All right, cool. So we're a little bit off on the cycle just because of the issues with the pumpkin and whatnot. RNG couldn't really deal with. But we're going to hide over here, honk, and we're going to move on. Iggy, if you have any donations, great time to get one or two in real quick.
Actually, yisk, get ready to run 90%. We have met the incentive.
Yeah!
Thank you, everybody, for meeting that goal.
You guys are in for a treat with that.
That is fantastic.
Nice.
So we're now in High Street. Don't blink. High Street is very fast. We got to put the boy in the phone booth. We got to get the boy to buy back this toy plane. Lady, can you come over here, please? Thank you. We need to break her broom. Not like that. That's fine. She's kind of RNG too. Physics is sort of a thing in this game. When it wants to be. Yeah, she's not going to catch us. We're the fastest goose in all of High Street. We got to get into the TV shop. We got to do that. And we got to get the boy's glasses as well. We just terrorized this poor child. He is going to have a thing for birds when he grows up. It's going to be therapy. Yeah, it's going to be a problem, probably. Not our problem, but his problem. So we took this apple because the gather task here is to go shopping, and one of that's not good either. Uh-oh. Come on, lady. All right, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, we're good. We have to go shopping in here, and so when the boy buys back soon, there we go. When he buys back his toy plane, it distracts the shopkeeper, and we can kind of undisturbed get all of these items. We got to get some canned product, maybe some beans. I'm not really sure what it is. This unknown cleaner here, that fruit or vegetable, which was an apple. This hairbrush. We also need to get some loo paper, which I believe in the States would be toilet paper, and a used toothbrush. Not specifically used, but that's really the only one that's available to us. We honk to cancel out an animation right there, and then lure her over with the leak.
How many tries are we gonna get for this toothbrush?
Yeah. First try.
Ooh,
how about
nice.
That? That is the trolliest toothbrush you've ever seen. And we're just gonna lock her in here. So we're just about done with High Street. We just need to finish up with the toothbrush, the loo paper. Oh, no, our cleaner ran away, so we're gonna fix that too. Again, not a big deal. One more second here, right. Oh, nope, that's the broom. There we go.
Okay,
all right,
good.
So once again, we're gonna carry something. That's High Street, and we completed it in the speed test. So we do two speed tests here. Yeah, we're gonna rock it classic here with the Viewmaster. Iggy, if you have any donations while we do a little goose travel.
Sure thing, we have a $50 donation from Xerxes, a $250 donation from Zach0624, a $500 donation from Steady127, and a $25 donation from Eric183. All these awesome donations share the same comment, a single word. Honk!
Honk?
Thank you, everybody.
So this is the back garden. We have the tidy and the messy neighbors, but those are really hard to say. So we just call them Roger and Tina. Roger can start off on a couple different cycles. That was teacup cycle. And we're gonna steal his slipper and his newspaper. The newspaper cycle is really, really long, and he doesn't need it for anything. That's a glitch.
That's a good glitch.
Yeah, it was good. That was a good hat clip right there. First try, every try. And we're gonna steal his stuff. So we took the Viewmaster because on the other side, we have to dress up this statue, AKA the bust, and we need an item for the head, for the eyes, and for the mouth. And so it's faster to get the Viewmaster or kind of a pair of glasses or anything like that. Than it is to just steal it from Roger. And it also provides a really nice distraction. A little dance, no big deal. There you go. We just want to distract her a little bit so that we have time to become a pretty goose. Who doesn't want to be the prettiest goose in the back garden? I don't think she's cooperating though. She's deciding, a lot of the NPC movement is all RNG, so sometimes they just go in ways that we don't want them to go. But we'll just lure her down here. And she'll fix the gate. Because again, all of the NPCs, they have various prioritizations and things that they'll do. And so the gate is super high priority for her. But when she looks away, there we go. She doesn't know. We are the goose statue.
She has no idea that there is an imposter where her statue was.
Bye.
Oh, look at that, it's a goose.
Yes, there we go. We are majestic over here, folks. Majestic. So we did miss the cycle here that we wanted to get. A little bit of time loss, no big deal. Back garden is routed really tightly, and so everything that we do is in a specific order, and most of it is so that Roger will not go to the bottom of his backyard. That's fine, we wanted her to see that. And so this is for the laundry task, that's the gather task here in back garden. Sorry that we lost the ribbon. I know everybody wanted to keep it, but it loses time to keep it on longer than that, so. Yeah, so for the laundry, we need to get the soap, we need a slipper from Roger, and we need the bra plus two socks. Oh, cool, she's coming down, awesome. So there's a really tight cycle that we're gonna try to make through all of this to get the rose clip, and it involves keeping her appropriately distracted. She is not appropriately distracted right now, so we need to fix that. And then Roger is also on a really tight cycle up top, where we're gonna get his slipper.
We'll get it.
Yeah, we are, and then we gotta turn around, show him his butt, assert dominance. That's how we do it around here. And then let him get chased down here. And,
Are we gonna make it?
I don't know if we're gonna make it here, guys.
It's gonna be close.
Do you think we're gonna make it?
I think you got it.
Oh, God.
You got it, just barely.
Oh, God, I actually think we might miss it.
Oh,
are we gonna miss it? Oh, we got it. That was a little close. A little closer than I wanted it, but it's fine. So we're not actually done with back garden. We still need to break this vase. If you play this casually, you probably had Roger throw it over, and you're gonna find out another way that you can break it. In the meantime, Iggy, more donations, please. I'm sure there's some great ones.
Fantastic. Shattermage 113 from your couch donates $10 and says, waterfowl day. If it would be the goose game, any percent doesn't get met. Well, it did, so don't worry. Thank you so much, Shattermage.
What a terrible pun.
$50 from MedMage3555 says, new task, raise $2 million. Honk! We're so close to that, too. Holy macaroni. And we have $385. We have raised $2 million, nice. People.
This is fine. This is all fine.
This is fine. All right. Awesome job, everybody.
Oh, boy. Love it. Do a little goose dance for a flower?
No, don't look at me, sir. Sir, thank you. So this is the pub. This is the final area of the game. This is also very frustrating sometimes and RNG heavy because the old man has very long cycles, two of them that we need to do, but we just got one of them out of the way. And the other is this lovely pub lady who is one part linebacker, one part Terminator.
The pubinator.
Don't
worry, she'll be back.
Yeah, yes, she will. So we're gathering all these things for the final gather task, which is setting the table. We also need to get that toy boat, and it has like a 20-second timer to it. So, you know, we kill two ducks with one stone. No killing of geese around here. And we actually did a great job. Normally she is way, way, way trollier than this. I don't actually know what, I don't know where she is right now. Oh, look at that, hey. Wow. That's cool. She doesn't know that anything's missing. That actually might be a problem because we do need her to aggro on all of the missing items. So we'll see how this goes. It'll probably be fine. In the meantime, we just need to watch the old man and make sure that we can get his dart cycle, because if we do miss that, it's gonna be 40 seconds of waiting around and just randomly honking.
What a shame.
Yeah, I'm sure you guys would be really disappointed with me just randomly honking for 40 seconds. Ah, see, there we go.
There we go.
She is seeing. Let's just check in. All right, so he's getting ready to go there. I'm not gonna do anything else and chance missing this cycle. That would be bad.
And
perfect. I'm not really sure what the pub lady's doing. This is kind of not what she normally does, but you know, we'll roll with it. And
would you say this has never happened before?
No, it's happened before, just not rarely.
All of this has happened before. It's,
yeah, just rarely. Rarely does it happen. So we did finish all of our items here. We did want to basically what we wanted to do was kind of honk and aggro her down here, but she decided to just do whatever she wanted. The fact that she wasn't trolling actually wound up coming back to honk us in the butt. And so we are on to our final task here. And that is to drop a bucket on barkeep, what on earth is he?
Publican's husband.
Vinny.
This is Vinny, yes.
This is Vinny.
Basically, he's our bouncer. He's our bouncer, Vinny. And
looks like Box Girl's not going to cause a problem today.
Yeah, Box Girl, no issue whatsoever. We do usually call her Blocks Girl because she tends to get in the way. This is just a swag clip right there.
Saves no time whatsoever.
Saves no time, but looks really darn good. We do have one last task that we have to do from the pub. We haven't done them all. Once again, just for routing purposes, it's faster to just grab this pint glass and drop it in the canal on our way to the model village. So completing the four areas, that is nice. Not the final part of the game. We do need to grab the bell and take it back home. This is where we're gonna kind of deviate from your casual play. We're just gonna go through there. I do need little Timmy though. This is little Timmy, by the way. Say hi to little Timmy. We're gonna use little Timmy to just hover up the castle and grab the bell.
Nice.
Bye, Timmy.
And then we're gonna swag walk over the model village and then just kind of pop back over the top. The model village is super cool though, by the way. I highly suggest you check it out. If you've played this game casually, you'll know that the bell return is incredibly trolly and frustrating to do. So we're just not gonna do it. Instead, we're just gonna clip
first
through the
try.
Game.
Nice. Nice.
And this has basically been Untitled Goose Game. I really just wanna do some shout outs right now as we finish up. And mostly shout out Rico, my fellow admin for the Goose Game Discord and moderation team. Rowan, who is the current world record holder of Glitchless and AMT. He beat my time a couple days ago while I was here. So you're awesome, Rowan. Everyone else in the Goose community, all you guys on the couch, everyone who's been pushing this down since it started.
Time.
That's time.
So 1543.
That's in the okay range.
Yeah.
I hope you guys enjoyed. This has been Untitled Goose Game. I do want to just a couple other quick things real fast before we give it over to Yisk for any percent. If you enjoyed Goose, if you actually were considering running the game, it's a short game. It's fun. There aren't too many glitches in the longer categories. A lot of RNG, but we have an any percent glitchless tournament that's coming up. You can check out speedrun.com/goose for invite to the Discord and find out more information. Signups are open for like 2 or 3 more weeks. Getting started, it'll be a lot of fun. If you enjoyed what I do here, you can follow me on Twitch or Twitter at Tasselfoot. And otherwise, I'm just really glad that we can be honking out cancer together and keep the donations rolling. In the meantime, we'll kick it over to Yisk for his awesome any percent bonus run.
Yeah, make sure to keep watching, because that's going to be fun.
Yeah, he's not even going to play the game.
He is not. He's going to not play the game really, really fast.
I play the game in my own way.
So.
Yeah.
Let's give it one more time for Tasselfoot and his incredible, uncanny run of Untitled Goose Game. Tass, before you go, we got a very special donation here for you from Armor Games for $385. They said, hey, Tass, we just wanted to say we're super proud of you, even though we don't really fully understand what you're doing. We wish you the best of luck with the bell, or was it a shoe? Actually, we're pretty sure it was a bell. Anyways, great luck on your run. Honk, honk, your coworkers, and dare we say friends, at Armor. Thank you so much. All right, we got a little bit of a setup before the Untitled Any% starts. So, audience, how about you help me out with these donations? Would you appreciate that? Thank you. We have $100 from Squeega. Their comment is a single word, one honk. The Robber sends us $300. Again, one honk. Bob90 sends us $500. We have a $1,000 donation from Orin956. Again, one honk, thank you. And we have a donation of $50 from Simon191. No, you baited. That actually said honk with an M. I'm so sorry. Let's try again. All right, let me make it up to you. There is somebody out there who has heard the hype in this crowd. He wants to hear it one more time. Cartridge Blowers sent in $25. His donation reads, somebody say honk.
Honk.
Say honk, honk.
Honk, honk.
Say honk, honk, honk.
Honk, honk, honk.
Let's scream. All right, all right, all right. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Carter. Thank you, everybody. Y'all are amazing. Yo, we got $1,000 from Link IGI, Linkigi. Hey, it's Linkigi. They say it's my birthday. There's no better present than a beautiful day watching a very fast goose. Oh, you ain't seen nothing yet. Woo! All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to see the story of a plate, a boot, and a goose who will stop at nothing to get that bell. I'm going to throw it over to Yisk for his Any% run of Untitled Goose Game.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to Untitled Goose Game. Quick reminder, if you joined us after the introductions of last run, I'm Yisk. That is Tasselfoot. That is Shattermage 113. Is that right?
No, just no numbers. Just
no numbers. Just Shattermage. That is ritzblues, and that is Aquana. And I'm Yisk. So the most important thing you're going to notice at the start of this, if, before we even do anything, is that I'm playing in German.
Why are you playing in German?
Yeah.
It saves time.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't, but I like to think that it does.
You got to tell them it saves time. It saves like one frame.
It saves one frame.
You know, all those text boxes you have to
save. One
yeah,
frame.
All right. So let's just get started because the, I mean, why not? So count us down. Five, four, three. Two, one,
honk!
So welcome to Untitled Goose Game Any%. It's the best category, in my opinion. The only category, in my opinion. The only way, right way to play the game. As you can notice, it's kind of glitching out a bit. I don't understand why. So we're going to grab this boot, and we're going to try to do this. I failed. That's it's fine. That loses like 3 seconds. That's nothing.
Yep, that's a reset.
Reset. I would have reset like 10 seconds ago. This was the run. So here we're just going to deviate from the path, go up there.
Praise Jesus.
Praise Jesus. Going to try to clip through here. Nice, first try.
Nice.
Walls are optional.
That clip is actually a lot harder than it looks. So there we're going to part ways with the boot. Say goodbye to that. Say hi to plate.
All hail plate.
Hail the plate.
So we're gonna just try to go through here. Come on. If it wants to cooperate. There we go. Nice.
Totally normal.
So yeah, we're already at the bell, by the way. It's been like what, a minute?
And 12 seconds.
Yeah, I don't understand why people would do tasks that's slow. So we're gonna ignore Timmy and just go up the edge here. There we go. And that's the bell.
Oh, I love it.
So now for the absolute worst part of the run, which is getting the bell out.
Why don't you just go the way that I went?
So there is a reason I don't go the way that Tasselfoot just went, and that is because there is a massive barrier around pub before you complete it, which is why we have to do that, clip through back through pub.
That trick is actually really difficult to do, by the way.
Yeah, it's one of the harder tricks.
But this one's the hardest.
And yep. Then for the absolutely hardest trick in the entire run, which I can fail, and this is not good. So let's just get it. There we go. That is really hard.
That is very hard.
It is possible to clip out, but that's a bit more risky than I'd like to do during a marathon.
At least you're just going to stare and watch you try to...
Yeah, I'm just going to let them drop aggro real quick, because clipping on the left side here is a lot easier. So let's just... Oh. Oh. Oh.
You get it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And that, my friends, is Untitled Goose Game Any Percent. That's the run. That's
Nice.
Probably the shortest run this GDQ.
3 minutes.
So I'd just like to thank my mom and my dad for bringing me here and raising me and the entire community. Oh. So time's coming up. And now. Time.
Hey, sub 3.
There you go.
Did I get sub 3?
259.
Well,
259?
Even with the showboating.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
The timer did stop for a few seconds, so.
So, that was Untitled Goose Game Any Percent. I've been Yisk. That's been Tasselfoot. That's been Shattermage. That's been ritzblues. That's been Aquana. This one was very, very short. Thank you very much for raising $150,000 and letting me showcase this. It's been absolutely insane. I was unsure if I was even going to be able to showcase this when we were sitting down before the run, because there was just so much money, and it's just awesome that you've raised all this. Thank you to the tech team for making everything here happen. Thank you to GDQ scheduling for, you know, opening up for, what is it, chase submissions and letting me and Tasselfoot run Untitled Goose Game here. And yeah, that's been me. Thank you.
If I can get one last thing in, I don't know if we covered it or not, but if anybody wants to learn how to speedrun this game,
oh right,
go to speedrun.com/goose, and there's a link to our speedrun Discord there. You can come and check us out. We're having a Any Percent Glitchless tournament starting at the end of this month. The more the merrier, double elimination. It's a great way to learn the game. Any Percent Glitchless is pretty simple to learn right out the door. So check us out. Yeah. Nice watching.
And just hijacking that, if you want to learn Any Percent, there is a guide coming up soon, TM, by another Any Percent runner who's very close to the record and might grab it any day. So yeah, that's been us. Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much, Yisk. Thank you so much, Tass. The whole Goose crew, thank you so much for that incredible, incredible series of runs. You guys have fans, by the way. We received a $10,000 donation from Panic and House House, the developers of Untitled Goose Game. They say, this is incredible. We love you all. Thank you for playing our video game. Thank you so much, House House, for the game and for the donation. Holy macaroni. Oh, man. We got $10 from Al Gindelrack. Says, honk and long train, everybody on board. Choo choo! That's right, we still have a lot of ground to cover on that Link's Awakening unlock. It's not gonna be much time to get it, but I believe in you guys. I've seen the magic happen. I can't wait to see it more tonight. Thank you. All right, I'm going to toss on over to a quick Twitch ad. Don't worry, we'll be right back. Don't touch that tab. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed that quick ad break. Welcome back to AGDQ 2020. And now, a word from one of our sponsors.
Hey, OmniGamer here, and my book Speedrun Science is the complete guide to speedrunning's process, history, philosophy, and so much more. Check it out at fangamer.com.
All right, guys, we have the Super Mario Maker 2 run setting up right now. But before that, Kungfufruitcup is going to be interviewing TGH about his upcoming, hopefully, Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening run. Take it away.
Hey there, Kungfufruitcup here. This is like, guys, this is like so in the way. All right, just scoot over. Here, I'm just going to come talk to you right here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's do this. This will work better. This is going to work better. All right, here we go. There we go. Now we can really talk. What's up, TGH?
What's up?
So I have TGH here with me. He is getting ready to do the Link's Awakening speed run. It's going to be amazing. See some hype from the audience right now. But I'm very excited. How are you doing?
I'm doing all right. I'm doing good.
Yeah, excited?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited.
It's going to happen.
Yeah, I'm hopeful for it.
Yes. So we are still getting donations in for that. Make sure that you all get your donations in so that we can see this run happen. But let's hear a little bit about the run so we can kind of know what we're going to expect.
Yeah.
Now, I know that this is a remake of the original. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit just about the differences between the run?
It's a completely different engine, obviously. Like, you know, you're moving from, like, a Game Boy game released in, what, 1993? To a game released on the Switch, like more than 25 years later.
Yeah.
So it's a completely different engine, made completely from scratch by Grezzo, and just like, you can't really expect two games and two totally different engines to be like exactly the same.
Right.
Exactly. It's like, I mean, there are similarities in the route, but like as far as how the game actually plays is completely different. But yeah. It's very fresh though, you know.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. I think that'll be really great to see.
Yeah.
Now I know that there has been, I mean, since it is a recent game, there's been a ton of development with a run in a really short amount of time, right?
Okay, yeah, it's been, like, actually absolutely amazing how quickly the game has developed, like, as a speed game. It's really come into its own as, like, just kind of a beast of a speed game. It's, like, mm-hmm. actually, like, really difficult, especially towards the end, like, the end game. Like, I hope you guys are ready to just have your minds absolutely blown by this run, actually. Yeah. Like, just, it's really insane, actually.
Yes.
And just the stuff you can do in the game is really, really, it's quite impressive looking, so just... Is now the good time to like push the donations a little bit more?
Absolutely,
like,
yes.
Like,
absolutely.
Make sure you get those donations.
I have seen, and I saw him doing some practice. Yeah. So far we are at 234,000 out of the 400,000. Come on, everyone! I believe in you. I know we can get this to happen. I really know we can get this to happen. I'm so excited for this. I personally love Link's Awakening. I had the original as well.
Yeah.
First thing I ever found a glitch
in my life.
I'm so proud of it.
Just a total, like, yeah, it was a really, really, like, big part of my childhood. Like,
yes,
yeah.
Absolutely. Yep. And I know a lot of other people as well. Mm-hmm. Now, with this run, there is some things you need to do before the run, right?
Yeah, so we have RNG manipulation actually before the run even starts.
Okay.
So... It's you power on your Switch, basically. You restart your Switch, and I time. Well, yeah, you have to start the game, right? You have to start the Switch, but the egg path at the end of the game, right? In the original, it was actually cartridge based. So you have five different paths that you could have, and it was all cartridge based. We only used one in the speedrun because there was used for debugging purposes, a one path that always worked for every cartridge. Here. It's a lot different. There are over 300 seeds, but we get the same one every time by actually starting the game the exact same time, every time after we power on the Switch, because it's based on, to the second, it's based on, like, how much time passes between power on and starting the game.
Interesting.
Yeah, so...
You can always guarantee the same seed.
Yeah, so it's funny how, like, something that is at the very end of the game can be controlled by something that happens before the run even starts.
Yeah, for sure.
Yep.
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, that's going to be amazing to see. Now, before we go, let's get a little social media going.
Sure.
Because we have a lot of questions. This is from @MissOAmerica. who says, were you able to use any knowledge from the original game in order to help route the remake?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Like, there are a lot of routing similarities. Like, for instance, like finishing Dungeon 4 last. Oh. That was a big thing in the OG game. And we do the same thing here to avoid a side quest.
Cool.
What else is there? I don't think splitting D7 was part of the original, but it might have been. I don't quite remember. There's a lot of different like routing similarities.
Yeah, sure. That's actually really cool to hear, because a lot of times it's so different. There isn't really much that goes from one to the other.
The knowledge of the old game definitely carried over to a pretty good degree.
Cool, and I'm sure that helps with the development of things. Mm. So we have another question from at @ScrivoSRL, who says, which iteration of Link's Awakening do you enjoy running the most?
It's hard to say because, like, honestly, it was so long ago. But I remember having a really good time with the original. I feel like I'm having an equally good time with the remake as well. This run's been a wild ride. It's been being a part of the community and everything. Because, like, I came into the original, like, once everything was developed. Mm-hmm. Once all the speed strats and tech were found and developed. And even though I played somewhat of a part in finding like little minor strats here and there, it's been a totally new and fresh experience, like being able to be a part of the actual development of the community in the game.
Awesome, that's awesome. One last super quick question. This is from Kizaron? I don't know who that is.
Kirazon?
I don't know. I have like a friend named Steven. I'm not sure who that is. Anyway, will they say when is Animorphs? I don't know what this is. I don't know what the tweet is. Wow, we should have skipped this one. We really should have skipped this
one. Yeah, yeah. I would say as soon as Kizaron learns Undertale, then I'll learn
Animorphs. Wow.
And Sonic 3D Blast.
Wow.
And Sonic 3D Blast.
What sass. I love it. Well, thank you so much for chatting. We are climbing toward that goal, but please, please, everyone, get in those donations. We want to see this. You've seen the energy he is giving out. We want to see this run. Thank you so much for chatting. And
No problem.
Let's do a generic throw over to Sven.
Thank you for that, Foo. I always enjoy the generic Passover, and I'd like to give you all a generic introduction to Sven's prize segment. If you haven't seen me before, my name is Sven, and I'm here to tell you guys about some of the amazing prizes that we have here. But before I do just want to quickly mention that Link's Awakening incentive is now about $160,000 away, and we have all of Super Mario Maker 2 to make that happen. So let's make that happen, guys. And in addition to that, if we manage to hit $2.3 million raised before the end of Super Mario Maker, you guys are going to get to see not only the very first Super Mario Maker 2 TAS ever, but possibly the first Switch TAS ever debuted here. Game's done quick. Let's make that happen. But first, let's talk about some of the great prizes you can donate for. So first off, of course, from our good friend Eyes5, we have beautiful Samus and Metroid plushies. You know, you got Samus, and of course, you have the baby. Don't separate them. You got to keep them together. That's why they come as a set. It's a $20 minimum donation. Make sure to get those donations in, everyone. Now, from our friend Jotato Chips, $25 minimum donation, we have an absolutely beautiful Steamboat Mario print. It's got a wonderful cartoon retro aesthetic to it. I love it. It's beautiful. $25 minimum donation. Make sure to get it in. And also for a $25 minimum donation, you can be entered to win this absolutely amazing oil on canvas painting from Ixie. So let's just grab that over here. You know, we got Mario in the Dark World collecting a star. This thing is beautiful. It's one of a kind. It's a hand-done oil-on-canvas painting. You can't just go to the Mario store and get one of these. Is there a Mario store? There might be, but you probably can't get one of these here because it's one of a kind. $25 minimum donation. We'll set that off to the side. Now, lurking about our main set somewhere from iggyzig, we have the Goose statue. You can take home the Goose, $25 minimum donation, and the Goose can be loose for you. Make sure to get those donations in, guys. Now, from Cute Monster Props, we have one of my absolute favorite prizes to talk about right now. We have this beautiful windfish statue from the Link's Awakening run. Like, it's just so colorful. It's so detailed. Guys, this is a handcrafted statue. It is one of a kind. $30 minimum donation. Make sure it happens. For a $40 minimum donation, you could win this beautiful Samus helmet string art. It's made of string and nails. It's incredible. How do you make this? I don't know, but $40 and it could be yours. And I know we're running out of time here, guys, but I even have a special new prize for you. If you donate $75 or more from now until the end of the marathon, you're going to get in for an amazing Sony prize pack. What's in that prize pack? Well, let me tell you. It's a PS4 Pro. Oh, it's two DualShock controllers in a new metallic blue color. I'm not even done yet because it's a collector's edition of Horizon Zero Dawn.
with an alloy statue. And I'm not even done yet, because it's a collector's edition of God of War with Kratos and Atreus statues. And I'm not even done yet, because it's a collector's edition of Death Stranding that's so big it hurts me to lift, and it's got a life-size BB in it. $75 minimum donation. Don't forget about the Yeti PC at $100. Don't forget our grand prize at $200. We have so many great prizes. Head over to gamesdonequick.com. Check out the tracker. It's got all the information you need. I can't yell anymore, so I want all of you in the audience to yell for me as we get hyped for Super Mario Maker 2 by way too many good runners.